In this part, you will learn how to pass the generated XML downstream and submit it to an API. So we start basically where we left with XML file destination demo, but I just exchanged and, well, I mean, I replaced XML file destination with XML generator transform. You can find it at the end in SSIS toolbox. And yeah, so what I did is basically I copied the mapping code from XML file destination. I pasted it here using this edit code button and editor. And then I modified input IDs to match the new ones. Okay, so so to submit, what we are going to do in this video is submit XML to an API, and we will be generating one XML per customer. So XML generator transform provides us with this option. There is this option output mode, and you can generate XMLs using several ways. So one is output one XML document for all the records, then we have output one XML document for each parent record, and also we can output it as a single dataset array. So we used the first one in our last part with XML file destination, and as the name suggests, one XML for all records option will produce one XML for all the records. By default, elements added under the root node here, right, get repeated with each dataset or upstream row. So all of the of those elements will be saved as one XML. Then we had a single dataset array, which we used in export XML task. And this single dataset array option enables us to stop repeating parent elements, and also let us produce an array using just a single dataset. So it also allows us to batch XML elements. So instead of generating 1000 XML elements, you can generate 10 XMLs with 100 elements each. So for our case, we will need to generate an XML for each parent record, and customer is our parent record because it comes from the root dataset. So we will be using this option. And before moving on and like showing you actually how to submit XML to an API, let me show you a couple of options you can use. So for that, let's add another element, name. It should appear, yeah, it appears at the end. Yeah, right click it, click edit, and here you have a couple of options. So one of them is output SC data section. So what it basically does is that it encapsulates your data in a C data section, and you can have any characters you want in that data, and they don't need any they don't need to be escaped. There is another option, XML treat value of this column as raw XML fragment. It basically, it's the same thing as with C data, except that it doesn't enclose your data in in anything in C data section, it just takes your raw value and put it into XML. So you can use this option, let's say if you have a column and which holds, let's say, XML fragment in those less than and greater than angle brackets, and you can check this option, and then those less than and greater than symbols won't be escaped. So basically your column will be treated as XML fragment. Another option is hide from output and include columns in downstream output. So use these two simultaneously if you want to output a column side by side with the XML generated. So I will check this and I will show you how this column will appear as input in another component. Okay, so yeah, we can move on, and now I will show you how to submit to an API. Let's drag and drop web API destination, connect it, it with the generator transform, right click, edit, then you will need to create a connection. I have a predefined one, so just, you know, to save time, and you can watch our other videos which discuss this topic in detail. So here you see, yeah, so to select the input column for body, select this ZSXML out, and this name is that other column we included downstream. So let's take this ZSXML out. It will be so basically this column will hold like two XMLs, I mean row by row. And then yes, and that's it. This has to be paused here, yeah. Okay. So we are expecting two XMLs to be submitted into API. Let's open Fiddler, a popular web debugger. It allows us to see what requests are being made to any of the websites. But before capturing the traffic, let's go to options, HTTPS, to enable to capture HTTPS traffic. Click OK. Let's start capturing the traffic. You can also press in here. And now we are ready to execute the package and see what requests were made. Okay, so we have two requests, one for each customer. Select inspectors tab and syntax view sub tab to see what was the actual XML that was submitted. Let's right click and click format XML. Let's also open an XML that was generated, and as you see we have here orders for customer sports arena, right? So just like in our generated XML using XML file destination. So same two orders, and then the customer. We can also go to subtab XML, so it shows a bit a more user-friendly view. So again, customer ID SA, just like here, sports arena, then two orders, and date and order data, well, basically all the same things. Then if we went to the second request, it's the request made for John Doe. So order for customer John Doe was submitted, just like in the original XML. So this completes XML generator transform demonstration and how to submit XML files to an API.